every time we ask you to go, child, I ain't going over there. I was already in church. Y'all don't know how to get out of church. You get to praying, you don't know when to shut up. You pray too long. They get to shouting, dancing, all that kind of hummer, hummer, hummer. Ain't nobody asked for no hummer. We gotta get out of here. Hello? We got this. But we got to have it with casting out devils. You find out people sick, don't be talking, Lord, heal them. No, I claim healing in Jesus' name. Be healed and be set free. You got power. And the reason why the church is at the state that it's in, because we don't exercise our authority. Prophesy healing. You see some folks that's not doing good? You say, I believe God that's going, God going to heal you. God going to lift you up. Oh, my God, I believe it. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you in advance. Amen. You don't want to be here. It's too much. You know what we'll do? We'll rush him to the bishop. Try to go to the bishop. I tell you, the bishop. Shut up. Why you care for it? God set the order that it all not supposed to be on the head. What you here for? Say no sideshow. When you search the scripture, Jethro told Moses, no, that's too much for you. Get your leaders and put them in charge of certain things. And if the matter is too hard, then take it to you. God set it up. Some folks, when you start checking, blame the pastor. You write in the name of Jesus. Y'all tell me y'all don't be laying hands on. Y'all don't be laying hands. Y'all better start anointing that stuff before y'all leave the house tomorrow. Put on your hands when you leave the house. Yeah. And let me tell you something. Don't worry about how many times you wash your hands. It's still going to stay. You got to have that stay in mouth. And then if you didn't have to wash your hands for anything at that point, be nice now. You didn't have to wash it. You see when the brothers and sisters, hey, praise the Lord. Bless you. You know they're afraid of that? Hey, right quick before you get to bed, glory to God, how are you doing? While you get in the hug, Lord, work it out. I got this. God will do some stuff. Anoint your children pillows. They're not always in the house, or they're not in the house all day. Don't pray. Lay hands on the pillow. Put a little oil. I didn't say put the bottle all over the bed. Some of us lost our minds. We get in, we get ready to go to the bed, pull back the covers. What is this? It's not supposed to be that visible. Let's not be stupid here. After you anoint your hand, you just rub the bed and believe God. Get the pillow, believe God. Don't just do it for the children. Sometimes the husbands need, hey. Sometimes the husband area needs to be anointed. Need to be prayed for. Yes. Sometimes the wife, have mercy. I stay on that call. Sometimes the wife. Sometimes, brother, you forget sometimes, like, you know what? Listen, I'm about to dump the whole Bible. I dump the whole Bible. She comes and looks and says, what is all this good stuff on my pillow? Chad, I'm praying for you, and I thought you needed to answer. She may not lay down on the thing all that often, but she got to pick up that pillow. We got this, Bishop. We got this. God is the boss. if we all just come together as a family and be in one place on one accord. Woo! What a time! What a time! We sometimes have to wait for somebody to come and hit the keyboard. We didn't have keyboards all the time. Y'all forgot about the struggle? I know y'all know about the struggle. About the scrub board. Yeah. And the scrub board that I used, listen, I was good for the scrub board, and it wasn't in church. And the first time I seen the scrub board in church, I was so happy because I figured it was a new thing now. That all the mamas in the world said, uh-uh, we're getting rid of all the scrub board, give it to the church. They need it to sign. We got to do this together. Because when you find out somebody in the church sick, it's not time to just leave it for the pastor or for the ministers. Yeah. Everybody needs to pray for that one or two individuals. You find out somebody going in revival, you need to pray. Hello? We got to stop playing games. So we need our heart fixed. Jesus is soon to come. If somebody said, well, they've been staying out for years. All right, how about a reality check? A car accident is waiting for you. A bullet is waiting for you. Hello? A knife is waiting for you. Now watch this.